Hello everyone, welcome back to the Regenerate channel. Dropped on February 16th, 2017 with the B version on the 17th, which fixed some of the serious random game crashing bugs, today we're diving right back into Semu with a preview analysis of build 1.7.2. We've been doing more in-depth analysis videos like this for a little while now, so if you've been following the Regenerate channel, you know what's up. For new viewers, the Semu Updates and Changes preview videos are about doing an ample amount of testing, compiling those results and presenting them to you in the best way that I can, hopefully in a somewhat entertaining and informative way. It takes considerable time to test all these games thoroughly, and I don't have access to early preview Patreon builds of Semu, so I'm not going to show you Semu at its best based upon Team Semu's Patreon build release statement. Of course, it's not my job to edit out any negative aspects of any particular build. You get it all here. You get the good, the bad, and the ugly. Whatever I'm experiencing, you're also going to see it. Part of the fun of testing and documenting an experimental piece of software is that you get to see how it evolves over time. I test it and share the results with you so that you know what to actually expect when you run it on your own machine with somewhat comparable specs. And if you're having trouble running a game that is typically known to work, we as a community help one another out to the best of our ability. We really have an amazing community of people who love to help one another out. So please don't be afraid to ask for help here on the Regenerate YT channel, over in the Semu Wii U emulator group on Facebook, the official Semu subreddit, or over in the Regenerate Discord server. That's what it's all about, and it's really as simple as that. With that said, this is the Updates and Changes preview for Semu 1.7.2. Another incremental iteration from Team Semu, Build 172 brings various optimizations and improved compatibility, bug fixes, and minor adjustments to the emulator. Getting the boring stuff out of the way first so that we can focus on what you're all really here for, info about the games that you really want to play, it's good to know that 172 brings a slightly revamped menu as some functions which were previously considered experimental have had some time to fully mature and can now be found under the options menu. There's also a new option here for full screen scaling, allowing the user to keep the default aspect ratio or to stretch it to your monitor's dimensions. Okay, some good to know information, but not incredibly exciting, right? What you're really interested in are optimizations and increased compatibility. There have been various graphical improvements and bug fixes from build 171 into build 172. Here's what I've discovered so far in my testing. Flickering, in many games like Bayonetta and Twilight Princess, have been addressed by Team Semu. However, despite some of the early reports, even with a full transferable shader cache and high GPU buffer cache accuracy, flickering is still present, as you can see here. I'm very happy to report that finally the freaky glitch bananas from Donkey Kong Tropical Freeze have gone the way of the dodo, sorry dodos, which we're all very relieved about. However, reports are that the cranky companion glitch is still prevalent. If you have footage proving this one way or the other, please share it here in the comments below. Other YouTubers seem pretty excited about Fast Racing Neo finally being able to go in-game. However, Team Semu warns that it might actually crash your graphics driver, which doesn't make the game exactly playable. This isn't a game that I'm personally really excited for, so I don't plan on doing any testing of it unless I see some interest from the community, so please let me know down in the comments what you'd like to see more of. I'll do testing on any title that there's demand for. I'm more interested in getting games like Hyrule Warriors, Pokken, and Tekken Tag Tournament 2 working, all of which in Semu 172 are running with better performance than in the last build, but still aren't playable. Hyrule Warriors boots back into menus again, as it did in much older builds of Semu, but it won't go any further than this. Pokken and Tekken's menus are also much speedier and are able to load more textures into some of the basic 3D environments, as seen here with Tekken's customizable character screen. But as soon as you try to play a match, the game glitches out into a nauseating trip of psychedelic flashing colors. Definitely not playable. With none of these games actually being playable, however, and frequent crashing occurring in many Wii U titles, there is still considerable room for improvement in future builds of Semu. Of course, for more information on these titles, in the form of my full testing videos, check out my Semu 1.7.2 testing playlist, as I continue to release videos over the course of the week, and you'll see what I'm talking about. And again, if you've discovered anything interesting, please share it with me down in the comments below. Part of the performance pickups seen in many Wii U titles, which are new to Semu 1.7.2, are in part thanks to the CPU timer now being set to host-based by default. According to Team Semu's statement on this, it's a risky move as sometimes a host-based timer can break games, and indeed, I've experienced this in many of my own tests. The reason why the host-based timer can be beneficial, however, is that when it's working properly, it will use real time for all internally emulated timers. This means that 1 second in the real world translates to 1 second in your game. Previously, with the default of the cycle-based timer, Semu would use the current emulation speed to drive internal timers for your games. This is a more accurate solution since it more closely can emulate the Wii U game speed. However, due to where Semu is at in development, and considering that this is an incredibly resource-intensive process, it can decrease performance on many machines, making it less than ideal at this point in time. So you'll want to play around with this setting still in some rare cases. For example, I've experienced issues with the host-based timer not always working properly, with FPS dropping significantly after numerous boot-ups of games like Zelda Wind Waker HD, which forced me to switch to cycle-based timer and then back again, trying to bring my FPS back up in Dragon Roost Cavern. I'll probably release a follow-up video of this in the near future to show you what I've been experiencing, but for now I'll tag the card to the previous Zelda Wind Waker HD Dragon Roost Cavern comparison for you to see what I'm talking about regarding the issues in this general area, and I'll update it with a new video once it's released. For Super Smash Bros. 4 and Paper Mario Color Splash, I couldn't even boot the game until I switched from host-based timer to cycle-based timer, which is quite odd, so something doesn't seem to be completely ironed out here with the timers. And I have no idea if this is a timer-based issue or something else completely different, but trying to load Yoshi's Woolly World with a partial cache of over 3,000 led to a cache compilation wait time of about 2 hours. I really have no idea what's happening here with these specific tests, and I can only really attribute this to the change with the timers. Something weird is going on here, so I'm hoping that Team Semu takes a look at it and is able to fix it for the next build, as I've never really had issues like this before. One last thing I'd like to add here is that I've just discovered something really impressive. When I began to shoot my testing footage for Captain Toad Treasure Tracker, I was presented with a new prompt. It seems that Semu is now able to read the save game data from Super Mario 3D World and use that data to unlock new content in Captain Toad. This, of course, is a feature present on the console, but I've been testing these two games for a long time now, and I've only just encountered this in Semu. A few people have told me in Reddit that this is a feature that Semu has always had, but I've never encountered it until build 172, and I think it's really great. If you can prove to me that this has been a feature of Semu since the beginning of game saves, please share it with me. I did some research, but I came up flat. Well, that was a lot to cover, but that's all for now. Check back to the Regenerate channel over the course of this week into next, as new Semu testing videos will be released daily. Most importantly, if you like this video and you want to see more content like it from the Regenerate channel, then please give a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to the Regenerate channel for updates. It really supports and helps the channel to grow so that I can reach people and continue to make more high quality content for you all to watch. For direct notifications on all of my video uploads, please don't forget to ring my bell. It's only a finger away. And to keep up on all Regenerate content, including getting sneak peeks on upcoming videos, please join our Discord server. We have an absolutely amazing community, and if you're also a creative, it would be great to have you join us. The link to the Regenerate Discord server is down in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Until next time, have fun, game on, and remember, don't forget to smile.